yesterday, therefore this morning, we reported 64 locally acquired COVID-19 cases, which we've reported today. 49 of these 64 are linked to known outbreaks. 15 cases having their acquisition source under investigation. 36 of the 64 cases were in isolation for the entirety of their infectious period. And this takes us to 701 active cases of coronavirus in Victoria at the moment, 697 locally acquired, and 4 acquired overseas. 42 people are currently in hospital, 13 are in intensive care unit, and 8 of those 13 are on a ventilator. And we send our very best wishes to those fellow Victorians who are battling in a really, really serious sense the coronavirus. There were some 55,333 COVID-19 tests processed yesterday, a very strong day, right across the suburbs of Melbourne, but very importantly in Shepparton, Echuca and Bendigo. There was a lot of household engagement teams out in those communities as well, with 1,633 such visits, with two-thirds of those being in the Shepparton community. That's a record day for those household visits for both support and compliance. And very, very high levels of engagement there. In regards to vaccinations, Victorians continue to show that they are committed to getting vaccines into their arms as soon as they possibly can, and as soon as both the state-run clinics and the GP and pharmacy and other distribution points can get those vaccines into Victorians' arms. Yesterday, there were 35,753 doses administered in our state-run clinics, bringing the state-run numbers to over 2.32 million doses. Every day, whether it's on social media or through messaging platforms or other measures, Victorians are proudly showing that when they are getting vaccinated, they are sharing that with their mates, their families and their broader community, because Victorians know that high rates of vaccination are the mechanisms via which we will get out of this pandemic, together with other public health measures. We've seen a really big demand over the past few days from Victorians aged 18 to 39, as they've really come forward to both our call centre and our online booking portal for state-run clinics, as well as approaching GPs and others in increasing numbers to make both their Pfizer bookings and their AstraZeneca bookings. And the thing that continues to hold us back in meeting those huge levels of demand is supply. Whilst we continue to see increasing levels of supply forecasted in coming weeks and months, what we really need is the supply to meet demand now. And we'll continue to ask the Commonwealth for more supply, because we know that with every dose of Pfizer, with every dose of AstraZeneca, that we will end up with more Victorians doing their part sooner to get us out of this pandemic. In regards to the actual outbreaks of COVID-19 across the state as well, we continue to see new wastewater detections. There's been another detection in the industrial estate in Sunshine West, and our testing teams from the department have been working very closely with the businesses in that precinct, getting lots of people tested, but there is still some undetected wastewater pings in that industrial estate. In recent days, there's been a lot of focus on emerging cases in the west and north of Melbourne, but it's not limited to the west and north of Melbourne. We have seen cases in the east and the southeast, including in local government areas of Manningham, Maroondah and Monash. And we've also seen positive wastewater detections in our southern suburbs. In particular, I want to call out the communities around Aspendale, Aspendale Gardens, Bond Beach, Carrum, Chelsea, Chelsea Heights, Edith Vale, Mordialloc, Patterson Lakes and Seaford. Across the dates from the 23rd to the 26th of August, we've seen in that wide southern catchment positive wastewater detections. So if you've displayed, even if you've been in those suburbs or in those suburbs and have displayed even the slightest symptoms of COVID-19, you need to come forward and get tested. There's plenty of testing centres right around the state and in those communities, and the turnaround time is very quick. We're well into the 90% for getting returns within the next day, and we need people to help us use the wastewater detection as the early warning signal to make sure that we stay ahead of the virus outbreaks. With the help of locals, we've also seen a substantial increase in the rate of testing in Shepparton and the surrounding communities. We had, on the back of the wastewater detection there, saw initial doubling of testing, which I'm sure played a part in helping us detect the cases circulating in that community. And that allowed us to mobilise the public health response as quickly as we possibly could, with the support of the fantastic Goulburn Valley Health and the local public health unit in that community, which saw the comprehensive response in that wider Goulburn Valley area. And that has led us to the position where there are currently 85 active cases in Shepparton, including amongst the numbers that we've reported today, 7 new cases from yesterday. Emergency Management Victoria is on the ground and supporting those local services and networks that have brought such a degree of support to the Shepparton and wider Goulburn Valley communities who are in isolation and doing their bit to run down this outbreak in that community. As I say, Goulburn Valley Health and the local public health unit are leading the charge there with their great work in contact tracing and testing, and we've seen the community respond to those testing calls in really solid numbers, with more than 20,000 tests being done in Shepparton this week. Rumbalara, the local Aboriginal Cooperative and Health Service, is working in partnership closely with Goulburn Valley Health, and they are working around the clock to keep their Indigenous, their strong Indigenous community in the Goulburn Valley both engaged and safe. The Department of Families, Fairness and Housing, Regional Development Victoria, the Greater Shepparton Council, the Red Cross and a range of other civic partners are doing a great job in supporting that local community in the way they are to keep themselves isolated and safe as they get through these challenges. I want to particularly thank the Ethnic Communities Council of Victoria, Uniting, Primary Care Connect and the Selvos, all of whom are part of the civic organisations groups from right across the state and right across the Goulburn Valley, who are getting together to get the Shepparton and wider community through these challenges. Whether it's through written material, bicultural workers, lots of online and other support work, WhatsApp, other messaging services, all of those groups are doing an outstanding job in connecting with and supporting their particular communities through the issues that the Shepparton community are dealing with. Emergency relief packages are being got out in record numbers and are available for people to continue to be supported through their self-isolation. Food, essential support, medicines, all the kind of things that people need are there, and the system has cranked up to record levels to make sure that the Goulburn Valley community get through these issues. Requests for any of these packages can be made by calling the coronavirus hotline on 1800 675 398 and pressing the option 4 to get you through to the right number. The Red Cross alone has been distributing hundreds of packages to support the community over recent days and will distribute hundreds more over the weekend as they respond to more demand. I might ask Jerome to go through the detail of the figures a bit more, and then we're happy to take questions. Thanks.
Thank you, Minister, and good morning. 64 new cases of coronavirus in the state today. That takes us to 701 active cases of COVID in Victoria. The Minister's gone through those in hospital. 42 Victorians in hospital, 13 of those are in ICU, 8 on ventilators. And in terms of the age profile, we have 60% of those in hospital are under the age of 30. 6% of all of our cases are under the age of 30, and 149 of our cases are under the age of 10. In terms of those who are in hospital, in ICU, in their 20s, we have one person. In their 40s, we have 8 people. In their 50s, we have 2 people. So again, a very young age profile for those in hospital. 26 of the 42 people who are in hospital are under the age of 50, and that includes one infant. We have 18,244 primary close contacts across all the outbreaks at the moment, and 17,230 secondary close contacts. In terms of the 64 cases today, 7 of those are associated with Shepparton, 10 are associated with our Broadmeadows cluster, 7 in the Carlton and Brunswick area, 1 associated with Altaqua College, and 1 case in the city of Dandenong. We have 9 further cases that are linked to cases we've identified in recent days, and we're still working on their linkages, but they are now connected. And we have 1 case under investigation. That takes us to 36 of the 64 cases today. An additional 21 cases are located in the western suburbs and linked to the western suburbs clusters, including 9 in Wyndham, 8 in the Newport and Altona North area, and 3 in the City of Hume area. And then finally, we have 7 cases in an area around Port Melbourne and St Kilda. That takes us to 64 for the day. 49 of those cases are clearly linked to established outbreaks and clusters. 15 of those cases remain under further investigation. We now have 41 cases in total under investigation at this point in time. 20 were cleared yesterday, so we continue to see good progress. And my thanks to our phenomenal contact tracing team and epidemiologists for the amazing work they're doing in giving shape to these outbreaks and giving us active lines of inquiry to work on. In terms of the major clusters that we're working on, Shepparton continues to be a very significant outbreak with 85 positive cases. That's an increase of 7 on yesterday. Over 9,000 primary close contacts and just great testing rates. 83% of those have now returned a negative test result. We now feel increasingly that Shepparton is starting to look like a very clear shape to Shepparton. We understand the linkages. It is all part of one significant cluster and a phenomenal response from the wider Shepparton and Goulburn Valley community. One of the new little outbreaks around Shepparton has been the aged care facility at Echuca, Warfarilla, where there are 88 residents. I can confirm that there was a staff member who tested positive at that aged care facility, and that is a confirmed positive test result. She has since tested negative. So the positive test stands and the negative test stands. We also have tests of her household, which is connected into the Shepparton cluster through work and other reasons, well established and all legitimate. We believe that household is coming to the end of its infectious period. We are doing serology work to establish fully the nature of those cases and what their timeline has been. We still have that infectious exposure at that particular aged care facility on the 20th of August. Testing was undertaken yesterday of all the residents and the staff. We still have around 40 staff on furlough at that location. It highlights again the importance of vaccination. This staff member was fully vaccinated, so we hope therefore to see very limited onward transmission, but the results will tell in the next day or two. I can confirm that 92% of the residents had at least a first dose vaccination, and the vast majority had already completed their second dose vaccination, which is a very encouraging sign. Of the 182 staff, 56% had at least a first dose of vaccination. A vaccination team was on site yesterday to do some additional vaccinations, and I believe some of those were taken up. In terms of the Royal Melbourne Hospital cluster, that has no new cases today. That's now a total of 19. We continue to have 372 staff furloughed at the RMH. And again, my thanks to the whole team at RMH for the phenomenal work they're doing to keep our critical services going.